Hi, I'm Jonathan Wesley. I do all things musical. I am a music producer, music teacher, and a performer. I want to share about what worship means to me. For me, the earliest memory of worship is from my childhood. Coming from a Christian family where worship and prayer was taken very seriously, you know, as kids, we had no choice but to wake up at 6 a.m., join the family for worship, and prayer, and you know, the family prayer was in full swing, and we were nodding in full swing trying to stay awake, but I mean, it wasn't all that bad because it was filled with music. My dad played many instruments, my brothers played the guitars and drums, and I played the keys and some other instruments, so it wasn't all that bad, and it was quite fun. But I think as a kid, I didn't realize the gravity of what we were doing. It sometimes seemed like a timetable or a routine that we had to follow. Only after many years, I slowly began to understand what worship truly means. I realized that as humans, we all worship something. Whether we believe in God or not, we all worship. And it's the object of worship that matters. You know, we can be worshiping money or our careers, our position, our self-image, or you know, fashion, food, whatever it is, we all worship something. And I'm learning that worship is a reflection of our relationship with God. And when you really understand how much God loves you, worship becomes natural. Worship is inevitable when we truly understand how much God loves us. When we try and wrap our heads around the depth and magnitude of God's love for us, you know, that God would send His Son to die for us on the cross, that He would take us as sinful as we are and take us out of darkness and bring us into His light, that we can have a relationship with this God, you know, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, who created the universe in all its splendor, and who breathes life into our nostrils, who suspends the earth in space, just at the right distance from the sun. But this magnificent God, we get to talk to Him, we get to worship Him, and the cool thing is that He listens to us and He hears us, and we get to take our adoration and our praises and our requests and desires up to Him, and He hears us and He answers us more than we can ask or even think. Why wouldn't you want to talk to a God like this? Why wouldn't you want to have a relationship with God? If this is what you're getting, why wouldn't you honor Him? Or why wouldn't you give time to spend in His presence? I think when we realize and recognize who God is, worship becomes natural. So when we are constantly rooted and grounded in this fact, in this reality that God loves us, it will radically change our life. We will gladly spend time in worship. It is only when we change focus from God back to ourselves, that's when things go bad. You know, we start fearing and we have doubts and we get into sin, and you know, things go bad. So worship isn't a one-time activity. It's, you know, it's not just going to church. It's a 24/7 thing. Worship becomes an outpouring of your love even when things go bad and situations, you know, are not the greatest. If you have a lifestyle of worship, you can face anything, and you know, you will not doubt, you will not fear, you won't be in confusion, because you are constantly worshiping God. In fact, your relationship with others, you know, your love for others would be so evident because you have a life of worship. There's a quote from J.D. Greer that I would like to use for this. I've changed it a bit, but I think it illustrates this well. If you think of a swimming pool, and if you think of a diving board on one end, worship is not just the diving board off of which we jump into this pool of, you know, faith or Christianity. Worship is the pool itself. So this pool of worship is where we are, and this is where we get to live life. And you know, whenever rough patches or rough waves come to us, you know, we will not fear. We will be able to face any storm when we are living a life of worship. So worship is all about God and not about us. We have the privilege of loving God and living lives of perpetual worship. So Sneha, my wife, and I, we are pursuing this lifestyle of worship. where it's not just worshiping, you know, in the morning as a morning routine or going to church, but it's an everyday activity where it's all about the affections of our mind and the meditations of our heart toward God that matter. So I'm thankful for parents who taught us what worship means or what living a life of worship is like. I'm sure we'd be doing the 6 a.m. prayer with our children too, and that we'd be living a lifestyle of worship through every situation of life.